nationally. So if when the results fail, so there must be also a huge outcry. When there's a problem, we must raise. And that is the only thing we are asking. Let them lead the process. And even when there's a problem, there must be a task force to check why there's this problem. Number two, the issue of the quality assurance and supervision. Parents are doing their best. They can talk to the child, they talk to the parents. But you know, there are standards. A parent cannot just go to school and sit in the classroom and see the standardization, scheme of work done, whether this subject was completed like this, methods of teaching the schools, whether they completed the syllabus. Parents cannot do that. It is actually the role of the Ministry of Education and TSC to do that. So because those are very specialized things the quality assurance officers or the school inspectors are supposed to look for. And TSC now has this decentralized TSC staffing officers, which in my area I know is not enough because I have two districts. And the TSC staffing officer is covering a distance of up to 400 kilometers. So he doesn't even, he tells me, I don't go to those schools, I cannot go. He doesn't have a car. He cannot go to all of them. Maybe he goes to the nearest 2-3. He cannot do that. So what we're asking is also that decentralized unit to bed many of them to be in place. But also, Madam Machare maybe has been here for I don't know how many years. If she has never ever gone to Wajir and even checked those schools, that in my school, is a school called the Jedibula Primary. It was the best improved schools nationally in the entire Kenya. Because last year, 2011, it failed terribly. 2012, it was the most improved school. And that I know what we did in that school. We basically said, what is wrong with these schools? We had to put extra, talk to everybody, and do monitoring, do quality assurance, do visits. So when we did that, it improved. So we only want when there's a problem that they do that, they follow. And then the teachers also. Teachers complain a lot about the TSC. But sometimes my teachers complain to me. Actually, right now, many of them complain to me. I tell them, that's between you and your employer. I have no issues with that. They have been transferred left, center, and right. A teacher has been there for 1 year. By the time he's there for 2 years, he's removed. So he gets demoralized. And, you know, he cannot see his results. If you leave a teacher there for, like, 4 years, he knows that the students he met in class four are the ones that are doing KCSE. And he knows that is his results, and we can blame him. But you remove a teacher after staying for 1 year, you see that's also a problem. And, you know, also the issue of the promotion that was just been discussed the other day, teachers having a huge problem.
Right, thank you so much. Because of time, we'll have to wind up. But there's a concern here. Perhaps Madam Macharia could respond to this. There's a report, a UNESCO report, that was published on the Daily Nation that stated that an average standard 6 pupil in Kenya is likely to be brighter than his or her teacher. Mm-hmm. That brings in the issue of competence among teachers.
Yes, I think I read something like that in the papers. Let me first tell Mheshimiwa that I have been to Madera, I've been to Wajir, I've been to Garissa. I have seen those schools, and I have sometimes had to walk long distances because even the vehicles would not get to the school. I want to assure you I know about the situation there. And Mheshimiwa, really, we are doing everything in TSC to alleviate these inequalities. It's just a matter of funds and the like. And we shall keep discussing these issues even after this. But to get back to you, to your question, yes, I read about that, and I want to say that I attribute it maybe to the fact that before we became a constitutional commission, teachers would only have the pre-service training just before they join teaching, and after that then they would not have any training. And that is why now we are coming up with the module, so that we are saying after every 3 or so years you'll have to renew your certificate after taking a number of modules, so that you keep up with the trends in education, and that like in all other professions you are abreast and competent. So I want to say that I could attribute it to that main fact that teachers just got training in college, and after that they sat pretty and they never got any more training. But as from now, they will have to renew a certificate after every 3 years, and that means there will no longer be such an issue.
Absolutely. Perhaps Dr. Mugo, you could give your final remarks.
Yeah, just to again caution, what we know in the system is that there's sharp disparity between inputs and outcomes. And when you listen to the discussion we are having, it's more about putting more money and more resources into it when nothing is coming out. So when you look at the money that goes into the system through the free primary education, through the free secondary tuition education and so on, it doesn't deliver value in terms of outcomes. And so I would caution Mheshimiwa to again check again, what is the strategic investment for your primary schools? Maybe it's not building classrooms where there's only one teacher. Mm-hmm. Maybe it's better to have teachers with children learning under a tree, but they'll pass because that teacher is working. Mm-hmm. Or maybe it is through building in accountability system for yourself so that you're not relying on TSC or the minister to come and monitor your teachers, but you can employ one person through the CDA funds who does the quality assurance for you and educating parents. So I would really say that such problems that we are having that are inherent in our system require also thinking outside the box so that the resources, the inputs we have can assure outcomes at the end of it all.
But that you are an educationist. I'm not an educationist. But you see, I don't think that's allowed, and I can be corrected, that here we have standardization. Every county or every MP cannot just employ a quality assurance officers to do that because there are issues of standardizations and systems and schemes of something to be followed. So if only we could...
But you can employ teachers.
Even teachers, you cannot just employ like that. Because, you know, you have to maintain the standardization. What's happening, like a student's brighter than his teacher. So we cannot just employ teachers the way we want. I cannot just put somebody quality assurance the way I want. Because this is the issue of the ministry and the TEC. There's quality assurance to be done and standardization to be maintained. So that is their work.
Many thanks indeed, because of time we'll have to stop there. But thank you so much indeed for coming. Talk to us about what's happening in the education sector. Thank you so much as well for your questions. We appreciate. We'll be right back.